So if everybody could go ahead and open up the chat that we have in Ventrilo. It's the third button down on the right-hand side, please. Thank you. We do have links that we'll be sharing with you during the meeting. All right, we got a lot of stuff going on, guys. We actually have a community meeting, community-wide meeting, on Saturday, April 2nd with Improventum. It's going to start at 6 p.m. Pacific, and if you happen to be a Swarm Lord or a Chapter Lord or a KBK, please know that we will be having meetings that are pre-meetings before the main meeting. So we will be in a lot of meetings that day. It starts at about 3 p.m. Pacific. So, now, everybody else just needs to be there at 6 p.m. For the community meeting with Emperor Venom. These community meetings are led by Emperor Venom himself. He generally does community announcements, chapter updates, has all the different chapters give updates, and any kind of high-level promotions are done at these meetings, as well as handing out awards. This is something for everybody. And after the meeting is over, we will be playing Team Fortress Classic. That'll be for everybody. We'll have a channel up in the community lobby. This is really fun because Team Fortress Classic is the first game that the Swarm played together. And it's kind of getting back to our roots. So whenever we have a community meeting, Emperor Venom loves to go and do Team Fortress Classic after. And it's a great time. Now, if you do not have Nylan, thank you for putting the link up. Nylan just linked to the forum thread. And if you read that forum thread, there is a link in there. If you do not have a copy of Team Fortress Classic, you can pick it up for just under $5 on Steam. There's a link there for that. Now, if anyone wants to participate and they cannot afford to buy the game, please email Emperor Venom. There's also a link there for that, and he will get you hooked up. So, no reason for anybody not to be able to participate. So if you do not have the game and you cannot afford it, Emperor Venom will take care of it for you. So we're looking forward to seeing everybody there. You know, as always, it's great when we can get together, have all the chapters together in one channel, you know, and get to hang out with Emperor Venom. So it's really a fun time. I hope y'all can make it. Any questions about that? We've got some events coming up in Guild Wars 2 as well. Now, Sunday, April the 10th at 6 p.m. Pacific, we will be having our very first in a long time Guild Wars 2 Interswarm PvP Tournament. And this is the first time that we will have it in our Guild Hall PvP Arena. It's going to be really exciting. The last man standing will be our champion for a month. And we will have these tournaments monthly. So at the end of the month, Bayor or whoever is our champion will be able to defend their title. And if we can get our upgrade done by that date, we will be having a free-for-all at the end of the tournament where everybody can fight against everybody else, and it'll be really fun. But there will be no jumping puzzle porting party that day for our tournament. Okay, great. So I think we have all of our, I don't see Nalan up on the steps. He's kind of over there. But I like to have our officers stand on the steps here in the guild hall so you can see who they are. I'm on your far left. Then we have Candid, who is also known as Valona Lane. She's our Vice Dungeon Lord. Next is Despion. Well, I'm sorry. Next is Nylan. He just ran up there. And Nylan is our media manager. He's also, and he's jumping up and down. That's our media manager, and he's also a swarm lord. So if you need a swarm lord, you can always go to Nylan. Despion is next. She's hopping up and down there. Despion is our lieutenant, but she's also our quartermaster. So if you have any questions about mats or something, or you need some food from the top tab of the bank, she can hook you up with that. Okay, next we have Alethea Luna, who is also our Lessa. Our Lessa is our herald, and if you have any questions about recruiting, she's your go-to girl. Finally, on the end, there is Azure. Last but not least, he is our Vice Warlord, and so he leads World v. World. If you have any questions about World v. World, that's your guy. So it's good to know who your leaders are. So if you guys have any questions or you need to get help from somebody in a certain area, they're always ready and able to help you and willing. So don't hesitate to ask them if you need help. Let's see what. Oh yes, we have another event coming up that's really exciting. Thursday, April 28th at 6 p.m. Pacific. Since that is a Thursday, we will not be having our meeting that night because of this event. That date is National Superhero Day. In celebration, we will be having another cosplay event. We've had two before, and if you've been here when we had those, you'll know how much fun they are. But we have a parade in Lion's Arch, and then we have a party, and we have a bunch of fun stuff at the party, water balloon fights and all that kind of stuff. But we also have judges who come and choose winners, and they get some fantastic prizes. So Elijah's planning this. She will get the event posted, but it's going to be on April 28th if you want to mark your calendars and start getting ready. Elijah, Critty, and several others are really, really up on, you know, all the fashion in Guild Wars too. So if you need help putting an outfit together, just tell them what you want to be, and they'll help you fix up, you know, your character to look like that. Now, there's going to be different categories for the prizes. There will be a category for male superheroes, and we'll award a first and second prize for the male superheroes. There will be another category for female superheroes, and we will award a first and second prize for that. Another category, which is really neat, is you design the next Guild Wars 2 supervillain. Just use your imagination. You know, we had Scarlet Briar in the past, who was a supervillain in Guild Wars 2. You design what you think the next supervillain should look like, and there's going to be a separate category for that. And then, of course, we will award a prize for Best in Show. And now, judges, we are contacting a couple of celebrity judges that we're going to try to get. If we are not able to get them, we will have Swarm Lords from different chapters come in and be judges. So that's what we've done in the past, and it was really fun. So does anybody, yes, Azure Celebrity Judges, I gave an email address to Eli since she's planning it to contact one celebrity, and she's contacting another person as well, so that'll be a surprise, but we are contacting and trying to get a couple of celebrity judges, so it should be really exciting, and it will be people you that are well known. That you guys have heard of. We're going to be advertising the cosplay event on third-party forums as well, so this is going to be open to the general public as well as our chapter. So anybody can be in it. So you may be going up against other people, but that's also a great opportunity for us to do some recruiting. So I think at our last cosplay event, so-and-so saw us on the main Guild Wars 2 forum and came out for the event, and then she told me, oh, I wish I was in a guild that did cool things like this, and I said, well, you know, maybe that can be arranged. So it is a great way to get our name out there in a very positive way and show people that we are active and we are organized, and we're also trying to give you guys some fun stuff to do until the next Living Story starts up, so. It will be Thursday, April the 28th at 6 p.m. Pacific. And just FYI, everybody, we always set our times in Pacific time because that's where our guild is based. You know, I know we're a global community, but Emperor Venom is in California, so we are set on Pacific time. So you may have to adjust, and like in my case, I'm in Texas, so I have to add 2 hours. All right, well, at this time, I'm going to move on then. I'm going to do our promotions. So, you guys know it's one of my favorite parts of any meeting is promotions. I just, oh, wow, Van says he has to add 14 hours. Wow. Well, we appreciate you staying up so late to be with us. And so, yeah, promotion time is really exciting to me. When someone starts out here, they start out as a newbie, and that is basically a trial membership or, you know, probationary period. It's not a full member. You're not a full member till you start, till you get to be a worker bee. That's a starting membership. Love it. Philippines represented. That's great. So, if you have any questions about what it takes to get promoted, please see any chapter officer. We also have a link on our ranks and titles page that tells you all the requirements to get promoted. We want to help everybody be successful and get promoted to at least Soldier B. There's never any pressure to go past Soldier B, but that is the last rank that is based on, you know, completing, you know, achievements, basically. So, we really want to see everybody get to Soldier B. So if you're a newbie and you do not have your worker bee yet, please let us know so we can help you do that. If you are having trouble with getting your post count up, we can send you some links and help you with that. You know, whatever the problem is, please get with us and we will do our very best to help you become a worker bee. And at this time tonight, I would like for Alara to come forward. There she is. Academy is the character she's on. Alara joined us recently, and she has completed all the requirements to become a worker bee. So she's being promoted tonight to worker bee. Congratulations, Alara. You are now a full member of the Sinister Swarm. Hail Swarm!
Hail Swarm!
Hail Swarm!
Hail Swarm!
Hail Swarm!
And if you're wondering, people, the requirements to become a worker bee are not really hard. You have to have 10 posts on the forum. You have to participate in game, you know, come to events and things like that. And you have to participate in Ventrilo as well. So that's all three areas of the tripod. You also have to, you know, just demonstrate the swarm qualities that we're looking for based on the 10 laws. So, you know, and you have to be in the community for at least 48 hours. I mean, well, it used to be 48 hours. Now it's 7 days. I'm correcting myself. I got in the habit of saying 48 hours, but now it's 7 days. So, yeah, it's my pleasure this time. I'm going to go ahead and adjust your rank in Vent. Now, if you've got the docs open, you can take care of it on the Google Doc. Alrighty, so yeah, that was awesome. So, and once you reach the Soldier Bee rank, since Emperor Venom redid our title system, it's kind of a big deal, because then you can be a chapter officer, you can be a battle commander, you can be a vice herald, you can be a vice dungeon lord, or whatever, you know, that whatever area of the game that you like and that you want to, you know, take on more responsibility in. Just come and talk to us about it, and we'll see, because we definitely like to put Poopy to work here, trust me. Alright, so next up is PvE. Our PvE leader, Bayor, is out doing some spring break stuff with his daughter, and our vice PvE leader, Valonaline, is here, but she is really not feeling well. But we appreciate her getting out of bed and coming to the meeting anyway. Thank you, Valonaline. So one thing I want to talk about in PvE is raids. Raids are something new that ArenaNet put in the game back when Heart of Thorns came out, and we were kind of, I guess, a little slow in getting started. You do have to have 10 people for the raids, and but it is a really fun thing, and we do want to have raids to offer to our members so that we're competitive with the other guilds out there. We want you guys to have fun. You know, we try to have something for everyone, you know, from new members on up, but we don't want the people who are, you know, at level 80 and they're ready for in-game content to go, well, you know, there's nothing left for me here. So we try to give something for everybody. So what we're doing is we tried to do it at two different days and times, but that wasn't working out. We didn't have the numbers to do that. So what we've done is we've moved our raid night to Wednesday. And we're doing it after the guild missions on Wednesday evening. Now, guild missions start at 6 p.m. And So we're generally done by 7 p.m. Pacific. So that's when we're doing the raids. Now, if we get done with our missions early, we might start a little bit early because it does get a little late for, you know, for some of the people on the East Coast, especially. And Nylan just posted something that is a new thread that I put up today in the raid section of the PvE forum of Guild Wars 2. Please get familiar with that forum because Eli is going to be posting some raid builds there. She's been studying on builds, and she would be glad to help you if you have any question about what build you should use. But since she may be at work or not on at the same time you, she actually, her stomach was feeling funny, so that's why she's not here. I've asked her to put up some threads on the forum with builds for raids so that people can go there if she's not around for them to ask in person. Now, we're really super excited about raids, and we've really enjoyed the first two times. We've done two raids so far, and we want to make sure this is a really fun experience for everyone. So moving forward, we do have some suggestions to keep in mind, and these are based on our 10 laws and our policies, so we ask that everyone keep that in mind. Currently, we have the raid one raid night, and hopefully in the future we'll be able to have two so that, you know, they'll be at different times and days that are better for some people. So our raid leaders are Bayor and Villonaline, and I just want to kind of go over this thread with you guys so you'll know what to expect. When we're up here in the main channel, we're all talking, it's kind of casual. But when we move down to the raid channel or the Worldly World channel, it's time to put on our game faces and kind of get more serious about things. So before the raids, we ask that you be on time, you know, grab your drinks and snacks, take a bio break, let the dogs out, and get there a few minutes early to group up. Be prepared, you know, make sure that your gear, your build, etc. is right for the raid, even have your correct food and things like that in your inventory, and be informed. You know, if you have any questions, ask ahead of time. You can watch YouTube videos to learn the boss mechanics so that you'll be prepared, and be in it for the long haul. You know, please set aside 1 to 2 hours for the raid and try to keep a positive attitude. You know, we're just happy that, you know, we've got to the first main boss and we've stood it pretty good against him. We got a little farther this time than we did the last time, so we're happy. You know, and always try to have a drink, snack on hand so that you don't have to get up and leave everybody waiting for you. Now, during the raid, we'd like everyone to be focused, listen and pay attention, try to limit the distractions, interruptions, you know, don't advance and pull the mobs before the raid leader signals to move forward and things like that. And another thing is being quiet in vent. As you all know, that when someone tries to talk at the same time as someone else in vent, you can't understand either one of them. And we don't want to miss a call. So we need to, you know, we call it raid silence. We're in the raid channel. So that means that only the raid leader should be talking, unless they ask someone to help out with calls, like Despion calls out when the green circles are up. And those members should just limit their conversations to the calls only. And sometimes the raid leader may bring in someone more experienced, like Frel, who's Eli's friend, you know, just show them the same respect that you would the raid leader. You know, also be courteous. Don't ask the raid to stop and wait while you swap out gear, purchase equipment, buy food, or clean out your inventory. Just try to limit any AFK time to the barest minimum possible, and be patient. You know, we're all learning. And if you have suggestions or ideas, please wait until after the raid to share them. You know, right in the middle of the raid is not the best time to correct someone or question the decisions of the raid leader. You know, if things aren't going the way you hoped, don't rage quit. You know, just try to stay calm. And after the raid, be positive. You know, feedback given in a positive, constructive way is always welcome. You know, so please give feedback in a calm, reasonable way and accept feedback in the spirit it was given. You know, we're all here to have a good time and we're here to learn and progress. And raids are a lot more fun if you win. That's just the bottom line. Lastly, you know, be open to change. You know, after the raids, you know, review the video recording and identify areas for improvement. You know, see what maybe you could do to do better next time. And listen to suggestions from your raid leader. Are you willing to try different ways of doing things? You know, we're just trying to help everybody be the best they can be. But, in you know, like Arles is typing, you know, raids are hard, but they're fun if we do them together. I always have fun with you guys when we're doing things together, no matter what it is. I mean, it could just simply be farming, and it's fun. But raids are a little challenging, so we need to really listen and pay attention. Any questions about that? All right. Nyla, if you could list the policies up there, too. I just wanted you guys to know that these are not just some things I came up with arbitrarily. You know, it is in our policies section in the critical info. And the same things that I was talking about, you know, that applies to World v. World, too. So when we move down in the World v. World channel, it's time to put on our game faces, too, just like the raid channel. You know, in the policies, you can scroll down and read PvP and battle commanding. You know, we need to all be focused and listen to our leader, our battle commander. Usually it's either Kara or Azure. And, you know, take that serious too and work together. And when we win, it's always more fun. All right, does anybody have anything to share about PvE? And I will go ahead and add that eventually, due to the game mechanics, it's set up in the raids. ArenaNet has already announced that it will require everyone to have full ascended gear to beat the final bosses. Right now, we're just in the first, you know, area of the raid. And you should be fine if you have exotic gear and ascended accessories. And some of the ascended accessories, you know, you can get them with laurels. You can, when we do guild missions, you can save up your commendations and get them that way. That's usually the cheapest way to get them. If you need help with that, let us know. And, you know, we'll be glad to help people with farming mats if they need to. So, you know, giving you some links and helping you learn how to level up your crafting so you can make some ascended gear. Nyla, you had a raise?
So if you're getting ready to do the raid, there's a couple places that you can look at PV that will help you.
Oh, dear.
Metal battle is where people put their builds for a variety of things and a variety of reasons to build a certain way. If you look at that, you'll find that you can see some builds that people have tried and have been found successful either in raids or PvP or that sort of thing. So if you're struggling with figuring out what kind of build you want to play, this is a good place to start, and you can try out some of the builds there. That's just one item. And then in terms of learning what the raids are,
thanks, Dylan. You actually reminded me to do something. I'm making a new thread in the PvE section of Guild Wars 2 under Raids for helpful links. So anybody who has some links like that and wants to share them, just can post them. But please make sure any links you post, you know, meet the swarm language policy. And by that I mean, you know, don't post any YouTube videos where people are, you know, dropping F-bombs every other word and that sort of thing. You know, just make sure that it is in line with the swarm policies before you post it. But I'm going to make a thread right now so that you guys can post any helpful links. Valonaline has also written up some protocols and ideas for raids. I haven't had time to read over it yet. I just got it right before the meeting. But she's really not feeling well tonight, so she didn't feel like going over it with you guys tonight. But I do have that, and she may go over with you next week. But she said it's probably pretty close to what I put up on the forum. Fantastic. Thank you, Nolan. You rock. All right, guys. So if you're looking for where this information about raids is going to be, you probably know where the Guild Wars 2 section is on the front page of the forum, and there are some sub-forums listed out to the sides. One of them is Guild Wars 2-PVE, and there are some separate threads for each, or sub-forums for each class for builds and things. About the second one down is called Raids, and that's where all the threads for raids are going to go. only have two in there so far. It is. So look under Guild Wars 2-PVE. And the top subform is Mesmer. And the second one is Revenant. And the third one is Raids. And I see that our PVE leaders need to go through here and clean up some of the threads that are in the PVE section, because a lot of them seem to be kind of outdated and things like that. Some need to be unstickied. I'm seeing some things back from 2013 and things like that, 2012. So yeah, looks like that needs to be cleaned up. So both of our PVE leaders have moderator status in this forum, so they can get that taken care of. Alrighty, I'm going to go ahead and pass to Nylan now, and he's going to go over lottery, tripod, etc.
Oh, gasp, okay. What did I just close it out? No. Alright, here we go. There you go. So, you all know what the tripod is: event participation, forum participation, in-game participation. Why do we talk about it every single meeting? Because if we don't talk about it every single meeting, we slip and fall. And it's not a slight on anyone. I personally have the attention span of 2 minutes. I am not kidding. So I have to be reminded as well. And so we just talk about it to remind everyone that it's all about keeping drama out of our chapters, because it'll grow. It's something that you always constantly have to, it's like weeds, you have to constantly be taking care of them. And so communication is what keeps the drama out of the whole guild. We've heard in the past, I'm sure you've heard stories. So please remember, always be invent when you're in any of the games, regardless of which chapter it might be. If you're playing different games, feel free to roam around the forums for the different games. They will tell you a lot about the different games as well. And for those of you who are newbies just coming up, don't worry, your forum participation will go up, and your access to more forums will go up automatically as you gain rank. And of course, in in-game participation, when people need help, if they're struggling in a group or in an event or in a raid, and you're doing your own PvE thing, it gives the appearance of very poor form. I'm not saying you're bad, anybody's a bad person, but it gives the appearance of poor form to stay in the quiet channel and not help when you see people are struggling. So please remember that you know, we don't see each other. We're hundreds of miles away from one another, and everything that we know about each other is our talking to each other on vent and what we post in the forums and in the game when we come to help others. I mean, Eli is amazing. She's not here, so I can talk about her. If you're not here, I talk about you. And she's amazing about being able to stop what she's doing and go help someone immediately. And I wish all of us could hold to that same high standard. So that's what the tripod's about. And then the lottery, I don't think I have the link up to the lottery, so I won't post it. If someone else has the link handy, go ahead and post it. The lottery is given out every week. You have to have your money into Kara Fox by noon PST on Saturday. Tickets are 50 silver. I'm sorry, 40 silver pence a piece. And thank you. Let me quickly do that so I can have it too. Okay, now it's on Twitch as well. Thank you so much. All right, for doing that.
Don't worry. Papers in triplicate.
We'll
be fine.
The lottery, as I said, it's 40 silver a piece. Most of us just buy 5 for 2 gold. If you don't have it, that's fine. For those of you who don't know, Kara's in-game email is Jasophine, Jasophine, .2851. And so it'll be done again, and we'll be presenting the winners for the following week at our next meeting. So that's the lottery. Any questions on the lottery? Sorry, I never give change. Exact change only. I have one other announcement for you. The question link is going to be right here on the main page. and you can see what my next picture will be. So I put that one up January 11th, and she found it a couple weeks ago, and somehow the automatic message didn't come to me that she did that, so I apologize for taking two weeks to find that. But I will go find another location, and it will again be somewhere where a 20 level or below can reach. You are welcome to use a party. Up to 5 people can win, and you all win the 2 gold, and then it goes up a gold each week. So it's not like you have to split the pot. You all get the actual pot. So by all means, it's helpful to get someone to go with you, and once you find the location, so you can spread the wealth. We would like that when you do that. And just take a picture of it with you all together at one spot. It's challenging to do the emotes. If you want to know how to do the emotes so that you all get them together, I can certainly help you with that. And then you post it on to the forum. If you don't know how to post on the forum, I can help you with that as well. Just give me an in-game email or a forum email. I'll be happy to show you how. And then you can win some money. So I've talked your ear off already on 3 items, and I will turn it back to Fate if there are no questions.
Congrats, Alchemist. I don't think he's here tonight, but congrats on winning 4 gold, and good luck to whoever decides to try to find the next hiding place. Thank you, Nylan. We really appreciate that. Another thing Nylan does is he hides a trivia question in our event lineup on the forum somewhere. And then if somebody finds it and copies it and pastes it in a reply along with the correct answer, they win a couple of gold too. So you can make gold just by reading the forum. I don't know. Well, you're checking on that. I'm going to go ahead and make another announcement.
Oh, you know what? The same guy who figured it out last time figured it out again this time, and he knows the rules that once you've won once, I'll ask you to wait one cycle before you win a second time. Same thing, by the way, on the map. So Alchemist Luca is not eligible for the next picture. And on this one, the trivia question, Despion actually does know the answer, but he's not eligible to win, so it's still up there.
So if they put the answer, don't you need to change the question?
He did not put the answer. He gave me a PM with the answer, but on the post he says I know the answer. So, but he was kind enough to, and he knew the rules, not to post it.
Oh, if you're talking about Despion, that's a she, not a he.
I knew that.
Okay. We were just talking about in the meeting about, you know, about, well, we mentioned Dolphy and her guides, and a lot of people think Dolphy's a guy, but she's not. She's a girl, and somebody's like, well, I don't know why people think she's a guy, or players are female, but, you know, a lot of guys have female players, you know, characters in games, so. All right, moving on. Talked about the cosplay event and the PvP tournament. I think that's all I had to fill in for Elijah for. So I'm going to pass to Azure next, and he's going to talk about World v. World. And then Arlesa is going to talk about recruitment. And then we're going to try to do a mission. And then we're going to have a trivia contest and some door prizes, okay? So Azure, you're up next.
All right, thank you. And Hellswarm.
Hellswarm.
All right, guys. Thanks for being here, everybody. Just some World v. World stuff. Just a reminder, a brief reminder of what our schedule is. Monday, we have our Heritage Night out in Edge of the Mist. It originally started off as a Surin Night. We thought it'd be a lot of fun to everybody run around there with the Surins and kind of progress from there. We said, you know, hey, why don't we do this with every different race in the game? So we started doing Surins, Char Knight, Norn Knight, Silvari Knight, etc., etc. And so every week of the month, we pick a race, and it's in alphabetical order. And we go out there sporting our, you know, our racial characters that night, or that week, I should say. And if there's an extra week in the month, we'll throw in the human race. But usually we just stick with the other four because, as I see it, you're human in real life. Why would you want to be human in a video game? But that is just my opinion. you do not have to bring a certain race for a certain night. You know, if you're stuck on a character that you're really trying to get leveled up, or you know, whatever the case is, you know, you really want to learn how to play a ranger or a thief, you know, that you made, then you want to learn how to play that. By all means, bring it out. You're always welcome to come and enjoy us, or come and join us and enjoy yourself. And but like I said, definitely come out for that on Monday nights. Thursday used to be our World of Your World night. Now we're doing our guild meetings there. So Friday and Saturday have been our World of Your World nights. Reset had been moved to Saturday. It has been moved back to Friday. World of Your World resets will now take place at 6 o'clock game time, Pacific time, on Friday evenings. And then I assume on Saturdays we will just continue doing regular World of Your World. What is reset night? Reset night is that day of the week where the other servers that we face is reset. Excuse me. They tally up the scores and they see where we rank, and based on our score and rank, they will pair us with new adversaries out in the Mist War. As you can see right now, this week we have Ferguson's Crossing, who are crushing it, and we are in second place, and Caning is behind us, trailing with 86,000. Being that Ferguson's Crossing is doing so well this week, they will probably move on after reset. So that'll be an opportunity to play some different servers. And reset night is important because that's our chance to go out there and strike the first blow and draw first blood. We always want to make a good, or maybe in this case, bad impression on our enemies on the first night of the week. So come out and join us for that. Again, that's 6 o'clock on Fridays. And then Saturday night, we'll have regular World of Your World. If you ever have any questions about World of Your World, contact myself, contact Kara. We are pretty much fanatical about World of Your World, and we love it. And you know, if you're ever out there, you want to do something, and one of us is on and available, grab us. We'll come out there with you. We'll show you around. We've gotten the new Borderlands down pretty good. I think we have a pretty good handle on getting around out there. Still some little things that I'm learning, but you know, we love running the new maps. They're a lot of fun, a lot of great stuff to do out there, a lot of opportunity to get loot, to get levels, and to get missions done for our guild. We do those occasionally as well, and great opportunity to get some favor for the guild. So come out and join us for those. Also, something to keep in your on your radar. There is a huge World v. World update coming within the next month or so. I don't have the date or the prospect date immediately available to me at the moment, but keep your eyes peeled. More information on that to come as we get it. I will be more than excited and eager to share that with you and get you guys pumped up for it. Again, we love going out there, but the thing that makes it so much fun is when you come out there and join us. You know, we can only do so much as one or two people, but we can do so much more as a whole team. We've been working on focus firing a lot out there the past few weeks, and I think that it's starting to click, it's starting to grab, and people are starting to get a better understanding of the importance of it. The quicker we can focus fire down a single target, the quicker we can move on to another, and then on to another, and whittle down their numbers really rapidly. Something that I worked on in the Terra chapter when I first joined, you know, a couple years back. It was a huge, huge tactic, and I think we're starting to see the benefit of using that tactic here. So definitely watch for that. And again, if you have any questions, you want to learn anything, you want to just run out there with somebody and see what it's all about, let myself or Kara know. And if you have any siege that you want to donate to the cause, you can again send it to myself or Kara, and we'll be glad to take that off of your hands and put it to good use. Any questions? Okay. In that case, I will turn it back over to our lovely Queen Fate. Thank you very much, everybody, and Hail Swarm.
Hail Swarm.
Hail Swarm. Thank you, Azure. Great job. And you guys, Azure does a fantastic job leading World v. World. So, and if you're like, oh, I've never tried it, I might not like it, come out and give it a chance. I think it'll be fun, and you'll learn to love it. It's very addictive. All right, let's see. Next up, we've got Despione, and she's going to talk to you about farming and mats.
Sorry, I can't type and talk at the same time. Okay, there's the link for the mats page in the forums. And every week I try to update what we are looking for as far as what we need in the treasury and the things we need for scribing that we send to Bayor. And if you just take a quick peek at the top of that forum, you'll be able to see everything that we need, and it'll kind of give you a better idea of what you might be able to help with. As far as the guild farming, this last week we decided to take a turn around Brisbane Wildlands, and I think that's the right place. I get the names confused at times. But we were able to go ahead and get a total of 25 gold, 51 silver, and 9 copper from the proceeds of everything that I was able to sell and donations that were made by members that weren't able to be there. We were able to deposit a few things into the treasury, and we sent over 300 softwood to Baywar along with a few other things he needs for scribing. And as far as the scribing goes, anything that you get that, is specific just for scribing, it doesn't have to be on the list that I have in here, but if you notice in the description, if it says the only thing it can be used for is scribing, it'd be a good thing just to go ahead and send to Bayor. That way he'll have that, and if he can't use it right away, he'll have it in his bank for when he can use it. Does anyone have any questions? Okay, I'll turn it right back over to Fate then. Hell Swarm.
Hail Swarm. All right, thank you, Despion. You do a fantastic job of leading Farming Night. So the two fundraisers that we have are Farming Night and the lottery. So that's how the guild gets money to do things like prizes for door prizes and trivia prizes and where's nicer and all those prizes. And it also allows us to do things like, when we have recruitment drives and cosplay events and things like that, so we can hand money out and prizes and stuff. So that's where the money goes. Alright, next I'm going to pass to Arlesa, and she's going to talk about recruitment.
Alrighty, hello everybody, Hail Swarm! Alrighty, so there is my first and actually only link I'm going to be posting today. That is a thread that you guys have probably seen before. That is the Guild Wars 2 Recruitment Blurbs thread, although it has much, much more than that. I'm sure you've all seen when you've been in a zone or a city, when people put little descriptions about their guilds in map chat to let everyone know what they're about and that they're taking new members. We, of course, love putting our name out there because we love having members coming in as much as we can. Not only do we get some awesome friends like Alara and Van who have joined us recently, but it also makes it so we can keep our numbers up nice and high so that we can do all sorts of awesome events, like, for example, the guild missions that require more people, or in the future when we want to form two raid groups instead of one, stuff like that. So it really helps to keep people coming in. Like I said, one major way that people do that is with those recruiting blurbs that they put in map chat. We have some example recruiting blurbs in that thread that I posted. It also has some tips for if you'd like to make your own. A lot of people who post recruiting blurbs, they'll find that some that they post get them a few more nibbles than others. So as you get more experienced with them, you can sort of tweak yours and kind of see, like, okay, so what do I think would appeal to people, give people a better impression of what we're about, stuff like that. Also some tips for stuff like how often to post them, as well as one of the most important sections of this is the frequently asked questions. This is especially important if you're first getting started with recruiting. A lot of people, they will send you questions when they see your recruitment blurb up, you know, asking questions about the guild, like what sort of activities do you guys do, what server are you on, things like that. And if you come across any questions that they ask you that you don't know the answer to, you can check here. If there's a question that they ask where the answer is not here, feel free to ask in Vent and Guild Chat, ask any of the officers, KBKs, anything like that. We will do our absolute best to help you. There is no shame in telling them if they ask you a question, you know what, I don't know that off the top of my head, but I will check for you. In my opinion, you know, that's much better than trying to sort of make something up on the spot, because you're much more likely to give them a nice, accurate answer, and, you know, you're probably likely to kind of give some gain some respect from them, too. So this is a thread that has lots of resources for you, but segues are awesome. That is not the only resource that you're going to have, because, as many of you know, I am currently on my Killer Bee quest, and because I am the herald of the chapter, Fate and Eli came up with some awesome objectives for me that are tailored to that position. And one of the things that I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be holding a recruitment clinic that is specifically for this chapter. You guys may have heard of the recruitment and orientation clinics that Fate does. They're every month, they alternate which one's recruitment and which one's orientation. They're on the first Sunday of the month. Now, we know that those are not always at a time that's good for people to go to. Plus, you know, obviously sometimes there are some sort of slightly chapter-specific things that can help out with recruitment. And plus, you know, it's if you're really nervous about giving it a try, it can help... you know, kind of hearing about it in a smaller environment with people that you're familiar with. So I'm going to be running a chapter-specific recruitment clinic just for you guys. We're thinking that will probably be on a Saturday afternoon in April somewhere. I'm going to be getting back to you guys on the exact date for that. I will not just be lecturing at you the whole time, I promise. I'm currently brainstorming for, you know, activities to come up with in addition to sort of introducing you guys to the resources you have at your disposal, stuff like practicing recruiting each other. You know, so there, don't worry, it won't just be listening to me for an hour, however long it happens to go. You know, it will be interactive and you will get to do stuff and, you know, get to have fun with your swarmies. That will be most likely a week before the second half of the kind of events that I'm running for my Killer Bee quest, which is the name that I came up for. It is the Swarm Ahead Recruitathon, where we're going to be having an hour-long recruiting event instead of having a recruitment drive. It's going to be an hour-long recruiting blitz. We're all going to, you know, I'm organizing some specific kind of methods and activities in order to do that, stuff like having a recruiting party in Lion's Arch and people going out with their mentor tags and answering questions or helping with events and starting zones, stuff like that. So we're going to have an hour-long intensive recruiting blitz event to so that you guys can practice everything you learned in the recruitment clinic. And it's going to be lots of fun, and hopefully we're going to be able to get some awesome new members in here. One nice thing about this is it'll be able to introduce some of you guys to recruiting if you haven't had a chance to try it. And one thing that I definitely want to go over in the recruitment clinic, because I know this is relevant to some of you guys, is what do you do if you're recruiting someone and it's not quite going the way you planned? Stuff like you suspect they may not be of age, or you're kind of getting weird vibes from them. You're like, I don't know what's going on here. You know, that can be very, very intimidating if you're very new to it. So we're going to be practicing some stuff like that too. Like, what do you do if it's not quite going the picture perfect recruitment experience. So we've got those events coming up. I'm going to be working on those threads this weekend and hopefully getting them up on the forum as soon as possible so that you guys will have that information at your disposal. And like Fate said, if you ever have any sort of recruiting questions, if you run into a situation, you know, like you're recruiting someone and it's not quite going the way you planned, feel free to ask me or any of our other officers. I'm sure that they've had at least small experiences with recruiting, so they can help you. So in the interest of time, I will pass the mic back to Fate, and feel free to message me with any questions.
All right. Thank you, Arlissa. I'm really looking forward to those recruiting events and clinics coming up. It's really exciting. You know, recruitment's a lifeblood of any chapter or community. So, you know, if we're not growing, we're dying. So we need to really be mindful of recruiting at all times. And anything we can do to help people be more comfortable with recruiting, you know, I'm all for it. It's got my support 100%. At this time, I was going to do a mission. But looking at the missions, well, we've got under the meat. We've already done the bounty and the trek on our mission night. We do have a World v. World capture, which we'll probably do on one of our World v. World nights, either Friday or Saturday. Then under the hard weekly opportunities, there's a trek. Unfortunately, we do need 15 people to complete that trek, and we're a little bit short because there are 30 targets. We've already done the easy trek. So what we're going to do instead right now, before we do our trivia contest, is I'm going to have you guys follow me over to our mine, and we're going to do a guild upgrade that's going to expand our mine. We are only 4 leyline infused tools away from being able to upgrade our mining rate, which will increase the rate the Ethereum is mined. But if you guys can just follow me, we're going to head over to the mine. We're passing by our market. And we're coming up on our war room. We're going to make a left, and we're going to go across the bridge. No, you don't want to. It's a long way down. But these lanterns are really, really cool. And if you follow the lanterns up to the left of that staircase, there's a pretty area over there. Now, this is where we're going to do our mine. So, if you've seen our mine, or if you've explored it, you can come down here. You can see this is what we have so far. I honestly don't know what's going to happen when I activate the upgrade to expand the mine, but I'm thinking it's going to make it bigger. So I'm going to go over if everybody is here, and I'm going to go ahead and activate that upgrade now.
Do you want us to stay inside?
Sure. Is it going to come down? I don't think it's going to cause a cave-in. I don't know, but Nylan, are you videoing?
Of course. I'm still in meetings.
Right. Yeah, we need a few more leyline infused tools to get that mining rate 3 up. So, okay, this is mine excavation 3, and I'm going to do the upgrade now, and just to let you know what all this takes is 1,500 elderwood planks, mithril ingot. I don't know who's PMing me. Let me tab over.
Not important, okay.
Alright, so it takes 1,500 mithril ingots, 150 silver waste shovels, 18 slot thick leather packs, 100 vials of linseed oil, 20 molten lodestones, and in addition to that, 1,500 Ethereum and 500 favor. So I want to thank everybody who donated those mats to make this possible, and everybody who has been doing guild missions to help us earn favor. And I'm going to go ahead and upgrade this in 3, 2, 1. Everybody, Hellswarm!
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 And we're level 37!
We got a nice cinematic!
It opened up the top.
All right. Oh, and looks like there's another platform up there. Let's go out and check it out. It's so exciting.
It looks like a jumping puzzle. Ah, don't miss that jump where I just went. You'll fall down deep.
Tech sounds.
You jumped.
Wow, this is cool. It's really big.
I'm selling. Are you buying?
All right, so I'm going to go ahead and pass the mic back to Arlessa so she can do our trivia contest. And while she's doing that, I'm going to tab out to random.org, and I'm going to get some door prize winners.
Alrighty, everybody. For those of you who haven't participated in the trivia contest before, we're going to be using the chat box and vent. So if you'd like to participate, please tab out because I will not see your answers if they're in the in-game guild chat, because I'm going to be looking at the vent chat box, and you don't want someone to steal your answer if they see it in the guild chat box. So the way this works is I have three questions prepared for you guys. The theme for this week, since we're talking about, you know, getting ready for raids, is going to be all about preparing for raids and kind of knowing what's coming. Okie dokie. So like I said, all your answers are going to be in the vent chat box. If you answer a question correctly, it's the first person who answers it correctly. If you are awarded the question, then you have to sit on your hands and you're not allowed to answer any more of the questions. I don't have any backup questions, so please make sure that you do sit on your hands if you do get the answer correct. If you get the answer correct, then you get 10 heavy moldy bags from Despian's lovely guild bank that she oversees. And it's for Soldier Bees and below. Our KBKs may try and put funny little misleading little red herrings in the vent chat, so be strong and don't listen to them. Alrighty, so the first question, like I said, the theme is raids for this week and preparing for raids. To make themselves as effective as possible in raids, people typically use two types of consumables that give them buffs. What are these called? Fate mentioned one of them earlier, actually. You know, I've never... Yes, Despion got it. It is food and utilities. I've never actually had chicken waffles. I know it's a thing, but I've never tried it. Alrighty, so Despion got the first question, so she's going to have to sit on her hands. Alrighty, the second question. Many people, when they're preparing for raids, they work towards getting their elite specializations, which you can unlock using hero points. How many hero points do you need to unlock your elite specialization? And this is hero points after you've already unlocked all the other stuff. I wish it were 40. It's a bit higher, unfortunately. Yeah, so you can start unlocking the elite specializations after you've unlocked all of the other traits and stuff. Ooh, you're very close, Flower. You're very close. I agree, Polonaline. Now, this is for fully unlocking the trait line that is your elite specialization. You can sort of start unlocking it and kind of put a few points in it, and they're like, yay, you started, and they give you an achievement. But this is for fully unlocking. Van got it. It is 250. And as Valonaline said, it used to be a lot more. I believe it used to be 400, actually. But then a few weeks in, everyone was very sad, and so they scaled back how many you needed. Alrighty, so the last question. If you aren't very familiar with raids, you may need to do some research for this one. Alrighty, so in our swarm raid nights, which we've had two, like Fate said, Wednesdays at 7 p.m. Pacific, we've so far done battle with the Veil Guardian, which is the first boss in the Forsaken Thicket. There are now two wings to the Forsaken Thicket, by the way. Name three of the other raid bosses in the Forsaken Thicket. It doesn't matter which wing they're in either wing. And there are actually more than three potential answers to this, but any three of the possible answers is fine. And for those of you who are doing some research, this may be a good time to check out the raid guide on Dolphy that Nylon posted. That will actually have a resource that will tell you the answer. If you guys need a hint, I can tell you the sort of base link on where to go to Dolphy's guides if you haven't been to her guides before. That would be pretty hilarious if there were were Pokemon. Yep, so Despion just posted the Guild Wars 2 section of Dolphy. If you're not very familiar with this, you know, it's a good way. That's sort of a hint, Jason, because the V is not one of the potential answers, since I already told them the name of that one. But Jason's giving you guys a hint there. He's giving you some initials. And again, these can be in either of the two wings that are in Forsaken Thicket. That is one of them, yeah, but I already told them the name of that one, because that's the one that we've fought in our raid nights. Do you guys feel like you need another hint? That's one of them, Alara. And also, if you'd like to, if you'd like a way to find them that doesn't involve looking on the internet, because I know, Flower, you mentioned that your internet connection is not the best, you can also look in the achievements section for raids. Okay, Alara, you've got two. Not sure how to handle it if multiple people host start putting stuff. If you can get one more, Alara, then even better if it's not the one that Van put. Because there's still one more. Yeah, since Van already got one, then I will, and it looks like Alara's almost got it. If you can get one more, Alara, then you got the prize. Awesome job. So the ones that Alara put are Sabatha, Gorseval, and Matthias. Well, Jason, I know there's also a Slothazor. I know that there's a couple other fights in there, but I haven't done them before, so I'm not quite sure how to name them. In my opinion, Slothazor totally looks like a Pokemon. I don't know about anybody else. And he's even got, like, Fire Breath that's like a Pokemon would totally have, you know, Fire Breath. But yeah, so congratulations to our winners. We have Despion, we have Van, and we have Alara. Thanks for participating, everybody.
All right. Congrats to our winners, and thank you, Arlesa. Great job. I went and got some heavy moldy bags so that we have them available for the prizes. And just for the sake of transparency, I just wanted everybody to know a while back in Nylon, he received a precursor in-game. He got it himself. And instead of taking it and building a legendary for himself, he very generously donated it to the recruitment drive. And we offered that as a grand prize if we met our goal. Unfortunately, we did not meet our goal. We were not able to give it away. It's just been sitting there and not doing anybody any good. So Nylon did mention it tonight, and I've gone ahead and returned it to him so that he can put it to good use. We will definitely have some great prizes for the next recruitment drive. We've already had two people, you know, donate precursors, and we were able to give one of them away. I can't remember who won the first one. Starts with an R, but the name escapes me at the moment. But yeah, so I just, you know, you guys probably see the. I know there's like a log that shows what's been taken in and out of the bank, so I just wanted to let you guys know where that went. No, I did not keep it for myself. Alright, Despion, so we've got 60 heavy moldy bags in there, so you got enough for this weekend next week.
Awesome.
Alright, so it's time for door prizes now. The way I do the door prizes is I take a screenshot of Ventrilo, and I use random.org, and I just go down the list, you know, like, like, if we have 10 or more people, I do 3. So I just put 1 through 10 in the random number generator, and whatever number you are invent, that's who wins the prize. Now, the killer bees and up do not get door prizes, so it's for the new bees, worker bees, and soldier bees only. And we just want to, you know, it's just a token of our thanks for you being here. And if you win, you get your choice of a mini wasp pet, or 2 gold, or an 18-slot bag. So I want to go ahead and announce our winners tonight. First door prize winner is Flower Child. Congratulations. And which prize would you like, Flower?
He put in chat he'd like the 2 gold.
All right, 2 gold it is. Thank you. All right, our second door prize winner tonight also happens to be our newest worker bee, Ilera. Congratulations. And what prize would you like?
I'll take the bag, please.
Sure. Our third and final door prize winner tonight is Vansky. Congratulations.
Congrats, Van.
Hi, Van. Well, what prize would you like? 2 gold, an 18-slot bag, or a mini wasp pet? Bag it is. And Despian will get those prizes sent out to you guys. Thanks for being here. And Hail Swarm!
Hail Swarm!
Hail Swarm!
Welcome to Honor. Become part of our ranks and battle alongside of us.